boys. Hey, girl. Some happy birthdays. Mr. Henderson wanted me to wish happy birthday to Christopher Sims in Birmingham, Michigan. On September 19th, he's going to be 36 years old. Happy birthday, Christopher. Birmingham. Birmingham's a city in Alabama, too. Interesting. And let's see, Kirk over in Fort Worth is going to be 37 years old on the 23rd of September. Happy birthday, boys. Trick or pop for me. Oh, today, I ordered a new gasket for my refrigerator right here. The freezer door gasket was out. I don't know why it went out. The refrigerator door gasket's fine. Freezer door gasket's out. And the way you can tell if yours is bad is take a dollar bill or a paper money bill. Remove the keep me closed rod. Which I done tripped on, I can't tell you how many times. And slip the bill into the door. And if it pulls out with little or no resistance, your gasket's bad. It should be hard to tug out, in other words. So we're gonna change it out. And there's different styles with different refrigerators. First thing you're gonna need is the model and serial number, and that's located normally inside the refrigerator area. There's gonna be a decal, a stamp in there. I'll show you a picture of this one. This was a Kenmore. Kenmore is also Tappan, Whirlpool, and a whole bunch of other ones are made under. It's all same refrigerator. Same gasket fits a whole bunch of other brands that are all made in the same factory, and they just put different name tags on. So, we gotta get the old one off. Cut. Yeah, that's the entrance to my computer work area. And I can't tell you how many times I had to step over that in the last week while I was waiting for that gasket to come in, that door jam that I had across there, the shower curtain rod. And I almost tripped on it several times, so I put a bar stool in the way. So I'd remember, look down, step over this boy, or fall. So the first thing you want to do is take your gasket and lay it out flat. And see this, and give it a day. See this, it'll lay out flat. Mine is. Some may be kinked a little bit. You can take the whole gasket and lay it in a warm tub of hot water, a tub of warm water, to make it more pliable. And they mount different ways. Let me swing camera angle around to camera angle number two. Move out the way, barstool. You done did your job. This one is actually in a groove clip. You can see where it's all busted up there at the top. And we're going to get it out of that clip. Bob. It may even be glued in. Nope. It's just kind of a snug fit. So we got to pull it out. See down here, we're taking it out. Some gaskets are actually mounted with screws. And to get the new gasket in, we probably have to take all them screws out. Matter of fact, that's how it's looking now. Yeah, that screw strip's gotta come out. So, we gotta shut the refrigerator down, turn it off, and get a screwdriver thing and take all those damn screws out so we can release, or at least release the gasket and get the new one in place. Some of them clip in, but this one is screwed in. Oh, I'm ecstatic. I hate working on appliances. Let me get me a little driver out. We also want to turn the refrigerator off so we don't defrost the whole box. If this is going to take a while, you may need to unload everything into an ice chest, especially anything that's leftovers and stuff that can spoil really quickly, like fresh fish or something like that. But I don't have anything like that in this one. The milk will be okay. You know, it's not going to take that long with it off. Now we got to get on a float. Now let's take our new gasket and starting at the top. We're going to get it behind that metal strip and go all the way around with it. Yeah, I finally got it after a severe crick in the neck. It's a pain in the butt getting that gasket on there. I thought that was the clip-on gasket, but no, that's the 5,000 screws gasket. And then it got to fit in this special little groove. And it's hard to make it stay there while because you got to fold the gasket in half while you put the screws in and get, oh, it's a pain in the butt. But what I did find, this is a little tool made to put that piping around a window screen, replacing screens. And this little thin roller really work well. A pizza cutter may work well too, if it's not too sharp, because you could cut that gasket and it was $50. I found this one place that had it cheaper too. I'll put a link in the description box to it. You just type your model number in, and it'll tell you what gasket fits. Naturally, that's a side-by-side, so you got a freezer door and a refrigerator door. And different ones go in different. Some of them clip in, some of them attach with screws, and there's about three different styles, or four. But I got it. It's in the new gasket. Seals well. And it was cheaper than a new refrigerator. Gaskets varied in price a lot. This one cost, I think, about $59. And I've seen them as high as $125. Same gasket. Different places. Was Thrifty something. Thrifty appliance parts online. I'll put a link in the description box. Next steel sole. Many pops later. This is the next day. Just recapping. If you like what you see on my channel, please subscribe. Tell your friends. And as always, a boy, a girl, a bye. Yeah, to keep in context, I made a alligator pear salad, avocado salad, and my famous spaghetti and onion stuffed meatballs with Cajun smoked sausage. Yum. My homemade sauce, root beer cake, and my mom and them went to Freeman's Barbecue. Only cleaning the door seal areas. Don't worry about all that inside. Hey, boy, are you paying attention?